Yeah. Back on 100 Terrace Ave, it was me and little sister Missy, she my better half. Man, I wonder if they miss me and the things we never had. Was too young to understand it, so I ain't never asked.
Ron is bitter about this because he's a Queens fanatic and he's embarrassed. He said MC Shan let it go, man. He still...
Well, why don't you say this story more than listen to this story?
What happened was Fat Joe.
Right.
Thing with KRS.
Right.
KRS was showing all that. And this is important to get this from you because you are Juice Crew. You Juice Crew. Mm-hmm. That's it. You Juice Crew. KRS kind of be showing love. You be like, oh, Shan's my man, but you know this and this. But then Shan, I noticed he got on the IG and he seemed a little mad. He was like, yo, KRS bit my whole style. KRS, I was the first one that was doing the Jamaican inside the music. He said, yeah, Run DMC had it with the other dudes, but it was just a fusion.
Right,
kind of like the Aerosmith
right.
and the Run DMC thing, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But he was saying how KRS bit his
style. I saw that.
Oh, he ain't paying you no mind. Y'all know how that nigga do. Every time the pressure on that nigga, he go run to fucking England and stay there until the pressure is off and he peek his fucking head out. To see whether it's okay. Can I come outside now? Are niggas feeling me again? Eh. So tomorrow, y'all gonna hear my story. And I'm gonna tell y'all from fucking the beginning of Chris's whack existence. To how he stole my style. How he lied about a whole bunch of shit.
So, and me as a Queens dude, I'd be mad at my man Shaggy. I'd be like, yo, you don't gotta look bitter. It was a war. You battled. It was good. You took the L on that one. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
you
right,
won
right.
on Nas.
Yeah.
You don't like that, right?
But see,
you
know, like, I saw that. Yeah. The line he said, you said that he was mad because Cats kept hit, tagging
kept
him.
Tagging him in the post.
And he said about the reggae shit. Boy, he forgot to mention that he brought up Snow.
Right.
But way before that, he had some shit. Gazooka zang, bong bugga dong.
I remember that shit.
That shit was way back.
I remember that.
You know what I'm saying?
So, I give credit. And you got a unique view on this, man. Cause yo, you did some of Chris production,
yeah.
KRS production.
I did a joint for him.
But you was Juice
and shit.
Crew, yo. Like how?
I mean, well, see. I wasn't part of that battle shit. I came after that shit.
Right.
Like, and I don't give a fuck about that. That ain't got nothing to do with me. Really.
They
you know what I'm saying?
You in there, you was tearing shit up.
I came afterwards. You know what I'm saying?
Afterwards, yep.
And it's like, when I came there, I didn't know nobody. So it was
right.
like, it wasn't no shit like, this is my man, I grew up with him, and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, happening, like, Kane didn't even fuck with me when I first came there.
Kane's dope.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's a fact.
I saw that you were saying that. I also seen that you were saying that you was out before Rock, but then Rakim came out and
No. No, I wasn't out before him.
Okay.
I was locked up.
I was doing
my shit, but I was locked up.
Okay.
I called my man. My man said, yo, this motherfucker sound just like you, my nigga. It was a shit. So check out my melody. You play that shit to me over the phone.
Turn up the bass, check out my melody, hand out a cigar. I'm letting knowledge be born, and my name's the R. AKA, I am not like the rest of them, I'm not on the list. Catch what I'm saying, I drop lines like a scientist. My melody's in the code, the very next episode. Has the mic off and distorting, ready to explode. I keep the mic at Fahrenheit, freedom season, make them cola. The listener's system is kicking like solar.
I'm like, that shit don't even sound like me. I don't even know, you know what I'm saying? But then when I came out and I got on, everybody was like, yo, this nigga trying to sound like Rakim.
Right.
And I'm like, that shit just like,
over it.
That shit just,
I feel bad for
the shit out of me.
I feel bad for Rakim, because me and Ron talk about this. Like, the Lex Coupe was ahead of his time. Rakim was ahead of his time. These young boys is filthy rich now. If Rakim was here, this era spitting the shit he'd be filthy rich. He don't get no props. They just say he was one of the best, but that don't mean shit when a motherfucker come out next week and got a show doing 100,000 a show, you know what
right.
I mean?
So
that's just
man
crazy.
Nori said,
Cool
man.
G Rap, though.
Yeah, Nori, yeah. And Nori,
G Rap.
Yeah, Cool G Rap, never had a gold album in his life. Never sold more than 50,000 copies. No 150, 200 copies. But Nori, 200,000 copies, excuse me. Nori made a good point saying that he thinks they should have a pension for these rappers, these old rappers.
That's a fact.
Because then Melly Mel and these guys, they are hanging in there, but They deserve to get a check every month. Why not?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Who's not? These record labels should have a fund to pay these rappers who came out.
Because they made motherfucking trillions of dollars so far.
But these kids now are making big, big money. So it's funny you said you was locked up, because I was locked up too.
Right.
Years ago, 99. But
Tekashi
99, I got locked up. I came home, you know. I learned my lesson.
I'm talking about early 80s. Like,
I was locked up.
First time got locked up was 86.
Damn, man. You ain't fucking. You learned your lesson, though. You figured it out?
Eventually.
couple more tricks. Couple more tricks.
Yeah, that's so real. Yeah, you too real. Man. I love that. He's so real. Listen, Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Yeah.
What are your views on that situation, on everything?
I don't even know what's the interest in the nigga. Like, what's the intrigue?
You should ask me that question.
I might ask you, because I've been serious. After you finish, I'm gonna ask you. Definitely, because he don't give a fuck.
He has no talent.
Thank you. Trash. I bet you he's trash.
He got rainbow hair. And you know what I'm saying? Not for nothing, but you know what that represents.
Yes.
Yeah.
So how is the hood even attracted to that? And standing behind that. Gangsters are standing behind that.
I don't respect that shit. I told you, I don't respect that shit at all. I've been up top. 99R2681. That was the most worst time of my life. So my point is, you it's like he got rewarded for being a rat bastard. And I ain't telling nobody. I dealt with my situation and came home. Now, big man here said he got something to say. I just met him today. I don't know what he gonna say, and I don't give a fuck. So go ahead and get it, man. What do you think about that Tekashi 6ix9ine situation, man?
I mean, Tekashi 6ix9ine, he's just marketing
tool.
Genius.
That's what she said.
Right.
But Bronson had died already, though.
I think he died.
He said it died already. He said it's not working.
I think that kind of stuff don't have no substance. I don't have a dog in a fight. I ain't in the streets no more. I've been jammed up to it all that.
And I heard a lot of that numbers is fake.
Either way, if you notice, it's going away. People was interested when he came home. They just wanted to know what was going on.
Right. The curiosity.
But in reality, the loyalty and the real shit still win. You got a Ferrari, can't drive it. What happened to going back to your hood the way the people love and appreciate you?
Right.
If you can't do that, then you ain't saying nothing.
But they reward him with 11 mil. So what's happening to me is when his kid has a kid. So when his kid becomes older, son or daughter, I don't even know what he has, they're gonna say, "Daddy, you a rat?" He's a rat.
Mm-hmm.
He's a rat.
Yeah.
And Ron, they said the fuck about me. I know. When it was me to go, granddad, I buckled up. I was sad because my mom was hurt. I did my time, came home, and learned my lesson. And it takes people 2-3 times to learn. Granny manned up. Some people learn the first time. I learned the first time.
Mm-hmm. Was you there for It Was All Good just a week ago? With Too Short, the snitching joint?
Oh, come on. Yeah, no. I was there for that session. That song.
Wasn't there,
but I love that record. That. I love that record, man.
Yeah.
So, granddad, so now, this is the thing. When Rockefeller closed, it was a rough time for a lot of people.
Right.
I'm meaning me too. My daughter was being born. I had to fight back and reinvent myself.
Right.
Now, you being one of the legends, something new, doing your thing, you're killing the game, God is good, everything, then you die down. Is that when you said, let me start producing to get back on?
Nah, the thing was, I always was producing.
Oh, okay.
Motherfuckers didn't know that. Because I wasn't, you know what I'm saying, I didn't get the credit for producing my first album.
But you didn't know nothing about the game.
I ain't know
shit. You supposed
to
be produced by Granddad.